Hello students, I hope by His grace you are all doing well. Today is another day God has given to us and we are continuing with relative pronouns. That's GHS 1, relative pronouns. And what to look at relative pronouns. When we say relative pronouns, what are relative pronouns? We can see the examples there. Relative pronouns are the following words. We have who, we have whom, which, whose, what, and that. These are the relative pronouns. These are the relative pronouns. Who. Now, who is a subject which goes with either singular subject or plural subject. And whom. Whom also is an object. Whom is an object. Also, as I said before, that always the object, they take a preposition. Preposition. So, whom is an object is the receiver. And the who is the subject, the one who does the action. And the which is used for things and objects, or could be animals, could be anything. That is what which is used for that. And whose shows possession. If something belongs to me, you can use whose bag, whose book. So the whose is for possession, used to show ownership. Whose, used to show ownership. And we have what. What also could be in a form of question. Could be in a form of question. And that also could be in a form of things. Things, or could be things and persons or places. So just take note of the relative pronouns. We have who, we have whom, we have which, we have whose, we have what, and we have that. These are the only relative pronouns we have. These are the only relative pronouns we have. Who, whom, which, whose, what, and that. These are the relative pronouns we have. Now they say they link a subordinate clause. Subordinate clause. Now what is the meaning of subordinate clause? Subordinate clause is a sentence which cannot depend on its own. It must rely on the main clause to make a meaning. So subordinate clause means it's a sentence which cannot depend on its own. It must rely on the main clause so that the sentences becomes meaningful, so that the sentence will become meaningful. That is the meaning of subordinate clause. So they say they link a subordinate clause to a main clause. Main clause is a sentence or a word that can depend on its own, that can stand on its own and still be meaningful. That is the meaning of main clause. Still be meaningful. Subordinate must be on another sentence before it can be meaningful. Let's look at examples here. We have Paul is a ball. You can even bring full stop here. This one is the main clause. Paul is a ball. Main clause. So looking at the relative pronouns, who, whom, which, whose, what, and that, they come in between the two sentences. They link in between the two sentences. So this one is the main clause. Paul is a boy. The main clause. Who is the relative pronoun here? Is clever. So is clever is the subordinate clause. Is clever is the subordinate clause, and the relative pronoun is the who. So you can see in between, the who is in between. So Paul is a ball, who is clever. So is clever is the subordinate clause, and Paul is a ball is the main clause, and the relative pronoun is the who, joining the main clause with the subordinate clause, making meaning. So this is the main clause. Paul is a ball. Who is clever? Who is the relative pronoun, and is clever is the subordinate clause. So take note, the relative pronouns, they are in between two sentences, main clause and subordinate clause. Main clause can base on itself and make meaning, but subordinate cannot base on itself to make meaning. It must rely on the main clause. If you just say it's clever, who is clever? So you have to base on the main clause. The subordinate here must rely on the main clause to make a meaning. So Paul is a boy. Who is the relative pronoun? Is clever is subordinate clause. It's clever, it's subordinate clause. Let's look at the next example. She was a people whom I taught. The whom here is relative pronoun. She was a people, full stop. She was a people. This one also becomes the main clause. I taught is the subordinate clause, and the whom is the relative pronoun in between a sentence to make a meaning. Now, let's look at this. Whose back is this? The whose here shows ownership. It shows ownership, something that belongs to you, something that is for you. So whose shows ownership. So you can see, I said who, whom, which, and who. So this whose, it shows ownership. It shows ownership. So whose bag is this? You want to know who the bag is for. Whose bag is this? You want to know the person who owns that bag. So whose bag is this? The whose shows ownership. Ownership. Let's come to the next one. I have bought a wallet. Wallet is thin. I have bought a wallet which. So I said which also is used for things, places, objects, animals, things you know. So book, pencil, all these things are things. So you use which. So I have bought a wallet which you will love. So this one is the main clause and this one is subordinate clause. But the which here is the relative pronoun. The book which is one of my favorite is lost. So the book also is a thing. The which is the relative pronoun joining the main clause and the subordinate clause. Alright, and we have the boy to whom, and I said whom is an object, so must be in agreement also with a preposition. The boy to whom you were speaking has been arrested. The boy to whom. So anytime you see a preposition, know that the whom here is an object, and all preposition must be in agreement with the object. Just be mindful. All preposition must be in agreement with the object. So to whom you were speaking has been arrested. Let's move to this one. Let's look at the classwork here. Put in the appropriate relative pronouns, which means that you will get sentences that you must put in the appropriate relative pronoun. So let's look at this. The child whose parents. So which means that the parents here belong to the child. They belong to the child. So the child whose parents are dead is an orphan. The child whose parents are dead is an orphan. So just be mindful that you choose the relative pronoun wisely or correctly. Here is the boy. Who? The boy is not the thing. So you cannot say which. And I said which is used for things, places, and animals, and any other things. But who? The boy is human. And we use who for subjects, persons. So here is the boy. Who? So the answer is who. Who will be our next school prefect? Who will be our next school prefect? Let's come down. With dash, in bracket, whom and who. And I said all prepositions, they move with the object. And whom? Whom is object? Whom is object? And who here is subject? Whom is object? So anytime you see a preposition like this, must be in agreement with whom. Whom. Whom is object? Who is subject? Whom is object? Who is subject? So with whom? With whom? With whom? Don't say with who, with who, with whom, because the with here is a preposition and whom is an object and who is subject. So with whom did you say you went there? With whom did you say you went there? With whom did you say you went there? So with is a preposition and whom is an object. So all the time preposition must be in agreement with the object. So this one is the object and this one is the subject. Let's look at the last one. I saw the woman whose bag was stolen. Whose bag was stolen? So it means that the bag belongs to the woman. So choose the answer wisely. Whose bag was stolen? Alright, so this is the appropriate relative pronouns you have to choose when you have them in your exercises. Look at it carefully so that when I give exercise, you choose them wisely. Thank you. God bless you. Take good care of yourself. Bye.